morning, sir. I had a small basic doubt regarding the difference between what the indices and indexes. Like, they will differentiate that in the...
That's simple. Index is simple. Index is singular. Indices are plural. That's it. Yeah, see, in NSE you have n number of indices. Nifty is one index. Nifty 30 is one index. Sensex is one index for BSE. Within that you have CNX, IT, Nifty small cap. All put together we call them as NSE indices, BSE indices. So index is singular and indices are plural. Simple.
Why there was different indices for different platforms? Why can't we match?
So first of all, you have to understand why an index. Why we are looking at an index? Say for example, if I take my class students index, where are my students? I want to know, are they doing well? Am I doing good with my students? I wanted to know in connection with the student. Then what should I do? I will look at their attendance. I will look at their class participation. I will look at their energy levels in the classroom. I will look at their completion of assignments. I will look at their marks, midterm, end term, mini report. Final marks all consolidated. So all these things will give me one fair idea. In that way, attendance is one index, classroom interaction is one index, marks one index. Okay, all put together these are the indices. So when you look at for example price indices, we have wholesale price index, consumer price index, that gives the price trend in the country. In stock markets we have NSE Nifty and BSE Sensex. That gives how the markets are moving every day, not even every day, every second the market changes. So why is it changing? How is it changing? We wanted to know. Index is the right platform to know market direction.
Sir, I have a question regarding portfolio, sir. Every common man will look to invest just to, they will just see balance sheet and they will decide. But as an MBA grad, is there anything else that we can analyze and we can choose to invest?
A portfolio is different from looking at balance sheet and valuation. Valuation is all about parts, part of equity valuation. When you look at a company's value or corporate value or business value, you look at the business of the company. The business of the company, the financials of the company, the health of the company, performance of the company is seen in balance sheet and income statements. Okay? But you're talking about portfolio. When you're trying to construct a portfolio, forget about portfolio management. When you want to create a portfolio, say we are talking about equity portfolio. So you want to put your money of your own or others, right, into equities of different companies. So how to do that? You cannot pick up the stocks just like that. You want to pick up the stocks where returns are very high, risk is very less, right? So or risk is zero. Actually, it is not possible, but human beings being greedy, we want zero return and zero risk and maximum return. So for that, you need to be very good in equity valuation first. For stock picking, you need to be very good in industry, which industry to pick. Then sort it out to stocks, and you should also have a good understanding of economy, how economy is influencing industry, stocks, and make you create a portfolio. Okay.
When coming to the point of derivative equity margin,
yes, of course you have to pay a margin, because whether your position is a long position or short position, you may make money or you may lose money. So to manage their own risk, the brokers will demand margin from any kind of derivative account holder.
Like, the Indian government was allowed only 4 days derivatives like off. Like, why the government was not allowing like swaps or other derivatives?
No, it's not Indian government allowing. Indian government will do. We want to have financial innovation. We want to have all financial engineering products in India. It's not that. But who is asking for that? If you look at swaps and very innovative currencies, innovative engineering products of out of finance, they are more in Europe and USA, America. The point here is, as you said, futures are there, options are there in India. But check, I'm sure, I think more than 90% are just for trading. They're not risk management tools. But in USA, Japan or Europe, they are meant for risk management. That is the idea. They want to protect the risk. Here, risk management is not the criteria. If that kind of mindset comes out, yeah, we need to protect our loan portfolio. The banks think that. And one more thing, we don't have foreign exposure loans. We don't have that. But Americans and Europeans, they have. Europeans have American loans, Americans have British loans or Japanese loans. So that makes them go here and there, inviting a lot of risk. So swaps is mandatory for them. But in India, that culture is not there. Maybe in the future it will come.
How can we rupee derivatives
to Indian? The persons, for example, I am planning for a foreign tour. Okay, maybe I want to do some higher education, something in US. My plan is next year, 2020. I need to have at least $1 lakh. That's my idea. I want to buy $1 lakh. But I'm sure from now onwards, it is around 70. Yeah, I didn't check today. Sorry?
70.
Yeah, more than 70. It is 70. I'm sure that next year by this time it will reach 80. I'm sure personally. So I cannot buy the dollars directly. I cannot hold. There are a lot of restrictions on that. What I do is I buy rupee derivatives, which is one form of currency derivative. In India, we have rupee derivative against dollar. Okay, so when you say foreign exchange, rupee versus dollar, US dollar, rupee versus euro dollar, rupee versus British pound, rupee versus yen. But everyone loves to see US dollar. When you say rupee derivatives, it is with dollar, which is famous and is offered in NSE. So that makes an individual like this, I think this requirement is more for companies. So maybe you can ask me in that case why they are not going for options and so on, still the market is not active. Maybe that day will come for that also.
Sir, for me, I have a doubt regarding over the counter. What is that over the counter means and what are the things they deal with and where do they exist actually?
Okay. Over the counter is a mix of primary and secondary markets. I can say that. It is a market, I think in India there is one over-the-counter market, that is Over-the-Counter Exchange of India Limited in India. Actually before NSE, that is the first screen-based trading platform in India that was launched in 1990. Okay, and thankfully it is still existing. So this happens for all private deals or private contracts. Private contracts in the sense there is a private placement, bought out deals. Okay. And some derivative contracts like forwards. So when there are counterparties which are not known and they are not active like NSE and BSE markets, OTC is the only option for them. There is no other option. So OTC market attracts any private party within the country or out of the country to make them participate. So that is the idea. And thankfully we have one OTC market in India, that is OTCEI. You can check that.
What is the difference between spot price and derivatives?
Spot price is the underlying assets price. If you take M&M, Mahindra and Mahindra futures, right? Mahindra and Mahindra futures is price is given, and spot price means underlying asset is Mahindra and M&M's stock price. Similarly, if you have a dollar future, a dollar derivative. Exchange rate between rupee, Indian rupee and US dollar is the spot price, a spot rate in this case, and future price is in the derivatives. Okay, so the difference between the spot and futures could be at premium, at discount or at par. That depends on demand and supply conditions and market sentiments.
Sir, in case of buying the futures or options, does the open or closed rates influence the
effect?
Investors' open rates influence or the
closing
rates?
Like,
for the purpose of buying the futures.
Open rate means, according to you, what is that open rate? You are referring to what?
In case of futures, you can see the open rate on expiration date, and it is expiration date.
Yes, yes.
So, what okay. influences them to buy the future?
I think as I was asking her, I was telling her, she was also asking me, spot rate. If you are talking about future price, spot price is the only thing, nothing else. If spot price is dead, future price is dead. Spot price went up by 10% in a minute, or in a day or in a month. Same is the case with future price. But the difference could be premiums, discounts and that part. Little things may change. For example, if you take Nifty futures, now Nifty touched 12,000. Okay, so spot price is Nifty itself. Nifty future will be 12,000 little plus if the market is bullish. If the market is bearish, Nifty is 12,000, future will be 11,950, 11,990, something like that. That depends on the market
sector. Sir, how the commodity market is different from commodity derivatives?
Again, yeah, the same discussion. You are carrying the same chain. Underlying asset is the commodity. If you take cotton futures, underlying cotton market is the spot market. Mandi, cotton mandi is the underlying market for the underlying asset, that is cotton. You take anything, crude oil, you take gold, you take anything, rice, wheat, anything. Underlying market's price, of course, market to market, you have to check. If you say rice derivatives or rice futures, where is the real market for rice in India for settlement? You have to check that. For each commodity, center may change. For example, mirchi, red mirchi, Guntoru is a big place in India. So from one product to another product in commodity, underlying market differs. But there is a product. Product price makes futures price in commodities also.
Recently that onion prices have lifted up very highly, sir. Like we have seen, like 1 kg of onion went up to 40 to 120 in Delhi.
Yeah.
How the buyer will affect for that, like other business partner?
You're talking underlying assets market or futures market?
Underlying asset market.
Like underlying asset is a different discussion. It is not part of financial market, but there is as a severe opposition against commodity markets, as you said, onions. People are hoarding onions in the cold storages. Okay, the price will go up, and at the same time, they will also buy a lot of futures of onions, say for example. So that is making them rich and richer for no reason. So there should be a real control on the underlying market. Future market doesn't make any difference. As she was asking, underlying asset price is the price which influences futures. Commodities futures is fine. Whatever is underlying asset, then accordingly futures.
Sir, how it influences the price of future options, underlying asset price?
Same thing. Futures has nothing to do with the pricing. Okay? As she was talking about expiry date and contract and whatever. Say for example, we are in the month of November. So you have November, December and January. Okay? Like all the futures are on premium. Say for example, say Nifty. Underlying asset is Nifty. It is at 12,000. And markets are bullish and future prices are at premium. In that case, say November future is 12,050. December future will be 12,100. January future will be 12,150 or 12,200. That kind of difference will be there because long is the time, as your friend Roshni was asking. Apart from that, the price is dictated by underlying asset only. If Nifty crashes to 10,000, all futures will be around 10,000. Okay? So if you get into valuations, that's a different thing. You should consider time, you should consider interest rate, and you should consider the risk related to the returns on the underlying asset. These three factors make the price. Okay?
So why there will be a price difference between BSE and NSE for a single company?
Usually no. Why? Because you can check. If you let me know.
I saw for Reliance, sir. In NSE and BSE, there is 10 paisa difference.
10 paisa is nothing.
Yeah.
10 paisa is okay. What is the price of
Reliance? 1290.
So 1290 rupees, 10 paisa is nothing.
Yeah.
Okay. Why I am telling you is, if there is a huge price difference, there is an arbitrage opportunity. Buy in BSE and sell in NSE.
Okay.
But you have to take care of your brokerage. You have taken up your brokerage, stamp duty, security transaction tax, many things are there. You have to cover that. All put together, say for example, 50 pies is minimum, your cost. If any difference above 50 is an arbitrage opportunity. That you can do.
What is the margin for a share, sir, brokerage?
That depends on
company to company.
I don't know, stock broking, Zerodha is one company which brought revolution. Irrespective of number of shares, you buy one share or 1,000 shares or 100 shares, flat brokerage. Like it used to be there in futures or derivatives, futures and options. He brought it to equity also. That is highly customized. But usually people say for delivery, it is 10 pice. That is 0.10%. For intraday trading, it is 0.01. That is 1 pice. 1 pice for 100 rupees is the charge. And for delivery, means real buying and holding, and real selling and giving the shares, it is 10 pice for 100 rupees. Usually, it goes like that. But nowadays, I feel it is much less than that.
How stock splits will affect the developing nations like India?
A stock split has nothing to do with the development. It is an adjustment. Stock split, say Berkshire Hathaway, it was getting traded in millions of dollars. Warren Buffett and his deputy, Charles Munger, they didn't want others to participate in their company. That's the reason they didn't make their stock cheaper. Okay, Infosys was going beyond. When I was holding, I think I remember Exide Batteries was going 16,000, 20,000, even 30,000. They stock split. Why stock split means it is easy. Any company wants their shares getting traded aggressively in the stock markets. If your per share price is very high, its turnover every day is very less. I hope you get my point. So every company loves to look at their company's per share price at the lowest price. But its value will not fall. Its value will not fall down. In totality, the value of Apple is $1 billion. Even it splits the stock, number of shares increase. Increased number of shares multiplied by less price will maintain the same capitalization. That is internal to the company. And maybe related to markets, but with economy, it's not, it doesn't have any influence.
Sir, according to you, as of now, which is the best platform to invest, sir? If we have 10 lakhs liquid cash with us, in which aspect you will invest?
See, first of all, as you said, invest, the young minds have to understand there is a difference between trading, speculation, and investments. There is a huge difference.
Yes.
As you ask me about investment, you have to know about the Indian scenario, Indian economic scenario, future American elections influencing India, future elections anywhere influencing Indian business and economy, number one, and existing governments, central government, economic policy towards various sectors. According to me, now it is a seller's market. It is very good opportunity to make money by doing business. Okay, even they have given the helping hand. Nirmala Sitharaman has cut down the tax for selective industries to 25% to boost business. So this is a business supportive government. I can also say that this government is moving slowly towards a capitalistic form of economy. Gone are those days where India has, and I personally invite that. Okay, so in this light, if you understand the economy, which industry you are strong, you should know that. Is it automobile? Is it software? Is it financial services? Is it banking? Which industry you are aware? You should know. Then you read that. What is the industry growth rate? How are they growing? In future, what is the growth rate? And what is the support from the government? What are the restrictions from the government? And importantly, impact of foreign exchange rate. When exchange rate goes up, who is happy? If it crashes, who is happy if it crashes? That is industry. Then slowly, how to pick up the stock? You have to generate your own criteria. Okay, are you looking for penny stocks? Are you looking for dark horses? Are you looking for high liquid stocks? And you need to develop that. You are prepared for what? How much cash you said?
10 lakhs.
10 lakhs you said. So you start investing with say 10,000. You build all these things, political, economical, industrial and company related and stock market analysis related. You do all those things and do some investment 10,000 for 1 month or 2 months or 6 months and follow up. Then you will get the experience. Okay? But don't try to follow someone. That is an idiotic way of investment. Don't try to read Warren Buffett style or Rakesh Jhunjhunwala's style or some celebrity portfolio manager style. That is his or her style. You develop your own style based on their inputs. There's nothing wrong. Don't try to imitate.
Like we are selling that we do related to give an example of US dollars and gold. How can we, where we can buy that rupee derivative?
NSE is offered, but unfortunately it is not that active. Even that is my worry. It is very difficult to do that because no one wants to buy that because dollar doesn't move every day. Instead of that, there are many traders, their interest is in stocks. The stocks move, they are very volatile. You can make money within a day. I hope you are getting my point. It is offered. It is there available, but its volumes are very less. I need to check now what is the status of that. In NSE it is available.
There is any RBI involvement in the rupee derivatives?
RBI involvement is there for rupee derivatives related to money market and banking sector. It has given directives on that. That is related to money market. That is different. You can check RBI's circulars on that. Directives are very clear. It is available on RBI's website.
Sir, my question is about options. How does the risk-free interest rate affect influence the option price?
Yeah, as I was answering Manisha, how do you do pricing of futures or derivatives? Options again happen in the same way, but they have more premium because you have less risk. The trade-off or payoff for options is completely different when you compare it to futures. Okay, so for that reason, you try to give more premium to options. Okay, so option valuations models are there, I agree, but they doesn't work in an active market. Long term, if you are looking at say 3 months option, 1 year option kind of thing, yes, I agree with you. But if you are looking at November months Nifty options, considering risk free interest rate and all those things may not work, because immediate things like underprice assets, price volatility is more important. What is its standard deviation? What is its variance? I will consider. That's
how
more
does
important.
Strike price influence the options?
Obviously, at the money is active. At the money strike price, say 12,000 is Nifty. 12,000 strike price is very active. Then going above it, they are not active and they become premium, costly. And below it, which is in the money, they are rightly priced. But again, they are not active because you need to pay, say for example, you have 10,000 Nifty options. Then you need to pay 2,000 rupees for one option. It's very costly. Instead of that, you will buy 11,500 or 11,600 option. You will pay only 300 or 400. The pricing is right, but they're not active. So at the money is always active, highly demanded. So if it comes down to 10,000, 10,000 becomes at the money, 12,000 becomes out of the money.
Like in India, there are many MSE companies, MSEs, meaning
micro and small MSMEs, okay.
And also like small investors and small companies.
Got it.
Any financial services available to them, like giving them financial support regarding any housing loans, like if they want this personal.
Okay. First of all, there are many government schemes to support MSMEs, women entrepreneurship, techpreneurship for BTECs, MTECs, technological kind of thing. People who wants to export, industry-wise, every industry has a supportive system through central government's policies, through state government's policies, And of course, there are some missing links, missing gaps, because these young minds, they're not aware of all those things. Hey, who will take care of all those things? But people who are in Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore kind of places, they can access it. But other B towns or C towns kind of places, it's very difficult. I agree with you. But NSE has offered something called Emerge. Emerge is a platform for, I cannot say MSMEs, it is for SMEs, small and medium enterprises, not micro. Small and medium enterprises, they started something called Emerge. They can raise capital through this, like IPO. They can raise capital, like I was talking about OTC. They raise capital through Emerge platform of NSE, and they get listed in NSE itself. So if you, yeah, as you're talking about portfolio, if you find one good company which is known to you, and you can invest in Emerge, if you know complete details, you have done good fundamental analysis on that company, it's a great opportunity. Because earlier you couldn't invest in unknown company, though you are interested. But Emerge is a good platform for medium and small enterprises.
If they are interested in that, they can be listed in the Sensex too.
Yes, they come for the public issue kind of thing in Emerge, and once the issue gets over, they get traded there itself.
How credit agencies or credit rating systems will rate these companies there?
Almost like all the credit rating companies have a common scenario, how to rate and how to give A++, B or B+, whatever. Almost they follow the same thing, little this way, that way. Any credit rating company, when they evaluate a company, they look at the debt scenario. That is the first triggering point. How less, how more is debt for this company? That is fine. That's the starting point. The other is how good this company is to repay the service, interest rate service, or the principal repayment. Okay, so that is the starting point. Not only that, what are the business risk factors, market risk factors, political risk factors, outstanding cases lying in court of law, and disputes in the board of directors, okay, which are unsolved. They are not resolved till today. So they get into all the dimensions, 360 degrees dimension, and they give a credit rating and they justify it. This is the reason we have given this. I think credit rating earlier for public issue of shares, there was no credit rating. Only for public issue of debt, it is there. But for any kind of issue right now, credit rating is available. That's a good move for all, good thing for all investors in India. You can check credit rating.
Sir, will they know, the credit rating agents, companies will know how internal issues of
the
board of directors disputes, how will they know?
Yes, yes.
It
will come out. Maybe internal means which is related to the company. See, internal does not mean which is hidden. Internal to the company, external to the company. Recruiting an employee, it is internal to the company. Borrowing internal to the company, taxes external to the company, impact of taxes external to the company, it is out of control of the company, it is not in the hands of the company. Internal means which is part of the company. That's how I said internal. Okay, maybe that's where you got confused. So all the internal things, sometimes even some things are hidden, they come out through media is there. Employees love to sell the information to media. You can say you are aware of what happened with Infosys. Okay?
Sir, again,
another
doubt. Actually, derivative contracts are entered for protecting the investors, right? Now they are traded. Will they lose the objective of protecting the investors?
No, first of all, there is no investment in derivatives. There is no investment in derivative. If you use the word investment or investor, investors get into derivative products to manage the risk related to their underlying portfolio. But it is hardly to find that. Everyone is getting into trading. Instead of full money invested in the company, I put a margin there and try to do the trading. But there could be some people who wait for dividend, bonus, and doesn't want to get out of the share, and they feel the stock price will go down. Yes, at that time they try to hedge their position with the derivatives. That is very less, I should say.
Sir, what is the difference between
euro
and cash market
price? IPO and?
Cash market price.
See, IPO is different. Okay. When it gets listed.
Yes.
Okay. Say, any recent idea?
IRCTC.
IPO price, IRCTC. Market price?
IRCTC.
Market price, IPO price?
IPO is 320. Like.
Okay. And market price? Any idea? Okay. IPO of IRCTC came with one price. And it got overwhelming response. It got oversubscribed some 20 times or 30 times. And obviously, there is more demand for that stock. 30 times oversubscribed means people are mad about that company stock. Then when it gets listed, okay, people will be crazy to buy that stock. Obviously, cash, the price of that company will go up. I hope you get the logic. Obviously, it will be definitely more than 300. Say for example, an IPO came, and it is hardly subscribed or little 2 times or 1.5 times oversubscribed. I don't think there will be a mad crowd for that company. So it will be as it is or it will fall down. Okay. So those who are investing, you should be very, very careful. People in the bullish market, they try to overprice their issue and come out of the equity of that company, right, at a very huge price, because that is seen. You can check many stocks. Like GIC is one, it came for the public issue, it got listed, and it is trading at maybe 60% or 50% of its stock price, IPO price. It, this way, that way happens.
886.
Sorry?
886.
See? 325 is the IPO price, and 886 is the, like Reliance Nippon, for me it happened. I don't remember the price. I got it for some 200, and it got traded for 400 or something like that. It all depends on the demand for that stock. Demand. Demand is the best example. IPO price and market price, huge difference. But this kind of examples are very less. The lower side examples are more. Market, as you said, cash price or market price less than IPO price. So you should be very careful. I was asking you to do fundamental analysis. You should read the company's fundamentals. Then only invest in IPO.
Any difference between letter of credit and the factoring?
Letter of credit is, of course, in domestic business also it is done. It is all about who is going to confirm or acknowledge and guarantee my credit. That is a regular part of business. Someone has to be there, then only the trade will be there. Okay? That is one financial service offered by, it's a banking service. Okay? Whereas factoring, it is also similar as you pointed out, but it is optional. It is optional. I am stuck with my credit sales to an extent of half of my total sales in a year. I think that is very worrisome. So I approach my factors and say that this is my problem. You please fund my factoring, okay? Fund my receivables. I need the money desperately. So factors come into picture at this kind of a dilemma. Maybe sometimes to recover money from the clients also becomes difficult. Okay? Before it gets a written off, I try to take factor services. That's also possible.
And what is the concept of forfeiture? Forfeiting
means giving up. Forfeiting the charges. Something like that.
Thank you, sir, for this personal interaction.
My pleasure.
With all your students. It made us to learn practically, and all the doubts made us how practically the things happen rather than theoretically. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. It's my pleasure, and I'm glad that the number is so good today. I'm thankful to you all. I wish you all the good luck for your knowledge acquisition and future career. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Nana, I had to go you too. ఈ క్లాస్కి ఏమైంది?
ఒకవైపు వచ్చి
ఒకవైపు పొగ కాదు ఒకవైపు పొగ ఒకవైపు మసి. మిషన్ అకంప్లిష్.